Hi everyone and welcome to our daily devotions for today, Friday the 19th of November. We begin our time together with our opening prayer. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, we like to think that faith is enough to save us, for we know that our deeds are poor and our witness is weak, incapable in themselves of earning salvation. We thank you that you see beyond our failures to our underlying intentions, and that when we acknowledge our faults, you are always willing to have mercy. Yet save us from using your grace as an excuse to abdicate our responsibilities, from imagining that the way we live and the service we offer are of no importance. Help us to understand that through faith, although faith does not depend on works, it must show itself through them. That the ultimate test of whether our lives are rooted in you is whether they bear fruit in your service. Teach us then, through the care that we offer, the love we share, and the service we give, to express our commitment to you, faith showing itself in action. To the glory of your name. Amen.
Mark chapter 8. The disciples had forgotten to bring bread except for one loaf they had with them in the boat. Be careful, Jesus warned them. Watch out for the yeast of the Pharisees and that of Herod. They discussed this with one another and said, "It is because we have no bread." Aware of their discussion, Jesus asked them, "Why are you talking about having no bread? Do you still not see or understand? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes but fail to see, and ears but fail to hear? And don't you remember, when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000, how many basketfuls of pieces did you pick up?" 12, they replied. "And when I broke the 7 loaves for the 4,000, how many basketfuls of pieces did you pick up?" They answered, 7. He said to them, "Do you still not understand?" They came to Bethsaida, and some people brought a blind man and begged Jesus to touch him. He took the blind man by the hand and led him outside the village. When he had spat on the man's eyes and put his hands on him, Jesus asked, "Do you see anything?" He looked up and said, "I see people. They look like trees walking around." Once more Jesus put his hands on the man's eyes. Then his eyes were opened, his sight was restored, and he saw everything clearly. Jesus sent him home saying, "Don't even go into the village."
Thank you.
Psalm 38. All my longings lie open before you, Lord. My sighing is not hidden from you. My heart pounds, my strength fails me. Even the light has gone from my eyes. My friends and companions avoid me because of my wounds. My neighbors stay far away. Those who want to kill me set their traps. Those who would harm me talk of my ruin. All day long they scheme and lie. I am like the deaf who cannot hear, like the mute who cannot speak. I have become like one who does not hear, whose mouth can offer no reply. Lord, I wait for you. You will answer, Lord my God. For I said, do not let them gloat or exalt themselves over me when my feet slip. For I am about to fall, and my pain is ever with me. I confess my iniquity. I am troubled by my sin. Many have become my enemies without cause. Those who hate me without reason are numerous. Those who repay my good with evil lodge accusations against me, though I seek only to do what is good. Lord, do not forsake me. Do not be far from me, my God. Come quickly to help me, my Lord and my Saviour.
We come now to our closing prayer for today. Let's pray together. Gracious God, we thank you that you are here by our side, wanting to meet us, to greet us, and to teach us. We thank you for being with us everywhere, at every moment, every place, and every occasion, watching over us as a father watches over his child. Day by day, you stay close, recognized or unrecognized, remembered or forgotten, obeyed or disobeyed, acknowledged or taken for granted. Although our response to you is varied and our commitment is often wavering, you are always the same, ever faithful, all loving, always true. We have no way of knowing what the future may hold, whether for good or for ill. But what we do know, and what we hold on to, is that you will remain the same, always there when we need you, and that nothing, finally, can ever separate us from your love in Christ. For that assurance, receive our praise in his holy name. Amen.